For the first time in 18 years, I thought I had a need to justify why I say things. Those people of earlier generations who I did workshops with are probably long gone. I can't remember anybody here who I've known for 40 odd years or so. Here's one. Oh, that's it. And I suppose my son David, yeah. Right. Yes. No, well, never quite accurate and so on. But all the same, I'm 79. Next year I should be 80. And I reckon it's time to give up. I gave up in 1997. My wife and I flew to San Francisco the day Princess Diana got killed. It put a damper on the several weeks we spent over in California and so on in the Morris. But it was rather fun because we were in these log cabins up in the wood. And what we did, what I said was, form up sets of six, choose your tradition and I'll teach you choruses. And that's what we did for the weekend. You know, there are a very large number of British invented choruses, you know, to impose on our American friends. Right, I need to say that, yes, I stopped regular dancing with a side in 72. Now, that is 40 years ago. Now, so it's a long time. I've actually just been teaching and not really doing. And I have been playing for sides since then. But the last few years, it's got impossible. And with my injury, I now find it impossible to play. The injury, I hope, is temporary, but still. I want people to realise, I've worked with a number of teams. You will notice the injuries. The Farnborough Morris was my... Farnborough Morris was a creation of Alan Browning on traditional lines. The people who met to form the side decided what they want to do is have intense Morris for 5 weekends a year with time in between going out to do other things, have holidays, for example. And they learned one tradition, a version of Bledington, on the basis that you didn't have to learn everything again next year and so on and so on. So a different style of side altogether. And that's been a strong influence on me because of my involvement with the traditional sides. I then worked with Mary Arison, a border. We were the original border side, but it was the Surrey Hants border, not any other one. And I worked with Jim Brooks in his cellar with the Thames Valley Men while we actually were going through the manuscripts I was collecting at that stage to see how to interpret these things. So quite a lot of the dances, as interpreted, date right back to 1960. To 62 sort of period. I went with my friend Frank Perslow to see the Abingdon Morris dancing, and they liked my company, so he said, would I come along to practices? So I did, and that was another strong influence on me because the older men were all rather like my father. I was 30, I suppose, a bit at the time, 30 years. They were like my parents' generation. There were people I could understand and get on with in a way that other sides weren't at that time. A very strong influence. I mention Oxford City because in those days, the average Morris club was 5 men strong. No women, 5 men strong. And Friday in was the ring everybody that you knew episode to see whether you can get a 6th or 7th dancer to make up the set. And as we all were trained to have the same common repertoire, it was never a problem, not in those days. That was one of the things which I set out to actually get rid of. I'll come back to that. Bath City, everybody knows Tubby Reynolds, or have heard of him anyhow. Somebody who doesn't, brave man. A tremendous influence on the people at Bath anyhow. And they must be the only university side that's ever run a ring instructional. You know what university sides are normally like, and so on. And then I'd more or less dropped out of things when somebody phoned me up and say, our musician has gone off with the squire. We're short of both somebody to lead and to play. So I went along to help Fleur de Lis for a while. And when they were going, Mindy Rose decided that they want, Alton Morris had been formed, and they wanted to have a women's side. So they came along and said, well, I teach them a few dances. So I ended up working with Mindy Rose on North Garland and Northwest. And then yet again, somebody came along and said, Squire and musician, who was the same person, Upham, was leaving Fleet Morris. Did I know somebody would come along and play? So I played for them for about 20 years. So that's my background, a mixture of women's sides in the last 25 years and men's sides before. Not just the only thing that I was involved with. Now, I mentioned these influences. Alan Browning taught me about Morris. Mary Orison taught me about clubs and fellowship. Frank Perslow taught me about the tradition. Through him, I met the Bampton people and Abingdon people and Chipping Camden. Jim Brooks, because of Thames Valley and the weekly workshops and so on, and what he did. Tubby, because he brought the fun into Morris. You know, somebody who was a typical Morris man, if you suggest something to him, he'd do it and then think about it. We reached a conclusion when we had a chat towards the end, saying we didn't want anybody to write about our experiences. We were very pleased with all the things we'd done, but we're not necessarily proud of them. Right? And Tony Barron is an American. Well, an Englishman. He was born in Bletchley. I knew him as an assistant professor at Boston University. The only person in the world I know who teaches Morris and folk song at a university level. And I gave him material to help the American Morris, and he, without telling me, published the material. Unfortunate for me, some people didn't like it. No, that's one I've done already. I'm putting him on the wrong heap. Sources. In 1958, I saw the Helm Index of Cecil Sharp, and I realised there was much more information available. So that's what set me off. I was able to borrow, when the government cancelled Blue Streak as a weapon, I had 2 years of marking time at work with not a great deal to do while we got another project underway. So I was able to borrow the microfilm reader and read the microfilm with the Sharp manuscripts. I was then loaned his written up notebook, and then they passed to me the field notebooks, the pocket books he used. So I got a good... I've lost the sound, have I? Right. I got a good grounding on what Sharp had collected. In the meantime, there are all these other names, so I went to talk to, in several visits, to Clive Carey, Douglas Maud, Ken Withers-Schofield, Rolf Gardner, the Reverend Fox and Tommy Atkins were members of the original Travelling Morris. Fred Hamer, of course, who was very active in the 50s. Major Fryer, who had been active before the war in collecting, and so on. So it was a fairly good thorough search of what was available in the early 60s. I then went into... Oh, I was also very fortunate. There were dancers to talk to. Besides the old men at Abingdon, whose memories went back before the First World War, that was Tom Hemmings and Jack Hyde. I was able to talk to people at Ascot and Fieldtane, that's Lee Field, who had formed a boys' side before and after the First World War, who were taught by the EFTSS to do Headington, and then taught the local dances, the local jigs in particular, to do. Ralph Honeybone at Evesham, for example, from Ascot, he could do Jockey and Princess Royal and so on. Now, these sources, oh, Mrs. Edwards at the post office in Ascot, these people were very important because the manuscript didn't tell us how the hand movements went. You know, we could only get enough details to reconstruct the edition by talking to these people and what they remembered. Bidford, again, I talked to the two sons of the leader, Sainsbury, who were being trained before the First World War to join the side, and to the girl, well, the old woman, who actually was the daughter of the man who was the hobby horse. Now, both Ilmington and Bidford, the hobby horse, was actually the person who taught, was the trainer for the side. An odd role, but when it comes back to it, the role for characters with the Morris is usually with the most experienced dancer. It was in those days. Longborough, it was again meeting some men who were in an attempted revival in the early 20s. Had been taught by Fred Taylor, and it was quite interesting again to see what they've been taught and how they've been taught it. And again, it changed my understanding of what Longborough was about, and that has influenced Old Spot, if you've ever seen them. And of course, Quarry, talking to Bill Kimber a number of times, and I also went to see Emily at Upton-on-Severn as a board of Morris. That was most interesting because I showed her photographs of the Upton-on-Severn Morris side, of which she claimed she was on the photograph, but she insisted there were eight of them, although there were only six on the photograph. You know, probably she couldn't see well enough to actually tell it wasn't the way so. But it was interesting to talk to people. Added to that, there was watching. Went to Bampton for quite a few years. 55, well, with Marguerite. Up to 82 was the last year we went. But we got involved, got very friendly with the Bampton sides, particularly for events that weren't on the Whit Monday, you know, going it when the other time. You know, the three sides were daggers drawn towards the end on the Whit Monday, but it's the same three lot were drawn on for the sides that went to do fates and things outside the village. The filming started in 62, and I've got a large number of hours of film and video for archive purposes, not really for... no matter how good the Morris looks, it feels at the time you do it. When you look at the film several years later, it's never very good. So I haven't actually tried to impose it on people yet. Stave dances was another thing which I stumbled over, and I have to mention it because people don't appreciate it. I was looking for traditional costumes, and I'd been to the various museums to see stave heads and see photographs, and then started to tumble across at Trowbridge in the county archives. There were notes in the various returns for the Friendly Society handed in about the dances that were being practiced, and that really started me off. Oh, the answer to my query is that everybody wore blue. It was the cheapest dye they could lay their hands on, so they wore a blue sash and a blue cockade on that. So that was considered the poor man's colour, and so on. But we did find a few dances. Knobs and Knockers were a Dorset set at Stallbridge, who many of them had emigrated to Priddy on the Mendips, where they formed another side. We did a workshop one Sunday with them. The weather forecast said snow will turn up, and we thought we could do the workshop for as long up until the snow started. But it rolled in. One moment it wasn't snowing, and the next moment it was a blizzard. It took us 3/4 an hour to drive to 3/4 of a mile to where we parked the car and left Marguerite. And we got home on a Tuesday. It really wasn't funny, really. It was quite sunny weather. We've run a workshop at Sparkford, and I hope that Somerset Morris, that's Barbara Butler, who's not here today, unfortunately. She's apologised for not coming. but somewhere in October next year, in a year's time, hopefully somewhere around Keynsham, we'll run another stave weekend for people to want to know something about the tradition. We have an expert about friendly societies and staves, someone who lives at Brixton, I don't know. What's that place on the coast? And a bend in it, they don't know. We have an expert from the, in the area anyhow to give give us a lecture. And what I hope is that we'd teach or go through the traditional dances that we've picked up, the ones that have been created by the eight or nine sides that do them, and to talk to each other about the problems of presentation or our experience of doing on them. That's a bit of an advert, I suppose, really. Instructionals. Some people run instructional horseway for 8 or 9 years until they put the price up and they got it out of the reach of Morris dancers. Cardiff men organised boys 10 at St Athlone. You have to imagine the Welsh coast on a January Saturday morning with the wind coming off the Atlantic and the snow, and there we are in an unheated gymnasium all wearing duffel coats actually doing Morris. It's the only weekend I know where on Saturday night we had to order another lorry load of beer from the Welsh brewery, and it's almost undrinkable to start with, but we did. And we were the only people who were thanked by the kitchen staff because we ate everything that was put in front of us. They said everybody else couldn't be bothered, but yeah. Those who survived that, unforgettable. The Morris Federation, one at Norwich I can remember, another one at Brighton and so on, and then the series at Lanes Bar and Wantage. Now at Wantage we were at, rather like today, about the sort of numbers I most enthusiasts turned up. All good dancers, good enough anyhow, that we were able to do quite remarkable traditional dances that one wouldn't dream of teaching in any other sort of workshop. So it was a good breakdown. Sally Waring actually videoed most of it, and unfortunately, if you want to ask Sally or ask Jerry Wist to look at some of the stuff, you might get something from it, but the video didn't have a broad enough angle at wider field of view, and the sound didn't pick up all the things that I said. So it's a bit of a mixed blessing. We were hoping that we could generate instructional from it, but it doesn't sort of work. And the bottom line is that when Border Mass started, for a number of clubs, local clubs to me, I ran a whole day of border dances, which I got from various people, without repeating myself. So for about 8 or 9 years, we didn't repeat ourselves on dances. That shows how prolific the Border Morris has been over the years. I can't forget Sidmouth, workshops, talks, lectures and so on. The lectures all exist as written up versions, and if they're not available on John Lewis's website, they right. Not the only visit to the States at all, but the only one to a Country Dance Society of America event. I think, Beth, you've been there, Pinewoods. Windsor went. Yeah, it's a very interesting experience. It's how you discover why the Americans are different to the British in terms of attitude to almost everything. You know, it's a long story, and if somebody wants to talk to my wife about it, and so on. Oh, yeah, yeah, yes. Don't take your kids to family week. American children are organised, whereas British children don't understand the word. I've been to the States for 5 tours, Australia once, and New Zealand once. If I can say, I took on the jobs, the visits, only because I visit the States professionally. If I say I visited the States professionally 130 times with my job. So I was used, I thought, to what it was like. But the difference of working with professional people, that's professional engineers and so on, and then actually being in people's homes of ordinary people like you and I, as it were, was enormous. Most of the people that we stayed with had two jobs just to keep their head above water and things like that. Absolutely fascinating. And they were devoted to the Morris as far as I was concerned. We did New England. Ah! Running a workshop on somebody's drive. Somebody was drinking a can of beer. He stepped onto the sidewalk. Police car picked him up and charged him for drinking in public. It's not legal in Boston. It's the only time I've had that happen to me.
Yeah.
Australia, we went to Adelaide for their annual get-together. Now, bearing in mind, in Australia, you travel a minimum of 500 miles to meet your next team. You know, if you drive from Adelaide to Sydney or Melbourne, you know, 500 miles, they don't drive to the day. That takes up a day. They drive through the night, taking turns to get there, to have a day's dancing, and then drive through the night to come back. It really is it's like having a weekend at Aberdeen. Can you imagine what that would be like, you know, going there for the day and coming back again, you know? And that's normal, because that's where they are by there. The people from Perth had to travel nearly 1,000 miles. It's quite incredible. Having said that, when I did the southern United States, when we got to, can you remember? After we were at Charlottesville, we drove down the Shenandoah Valley to the place beginning with A. No. Well, it doesn't matter. It's the capital of Georgia, isn't it? We got there, and it coincided with the big ball game, you know, the Super Bowl. Cars had started in the car park, started filling up on Thursday for the Saturday game. And they were still trying to leave by Tuesday. That was the town solid. Fortunately, we'd arranged to work outside. But a team came from Little Rock. Now, it was great. It was an unusual day because I came along to teach some dances, but I got them to dress up and dance for me. I've got a video of them, you see. So this team had driven over 1,000 miles from Little Rock just to do their dance for me. I was a bit embarrassed by that, I might say. 1,000 miles in the States is still a long way, you know. But that's the sort of distances. New Zealand has the same problem. Their week's tour this year will be at the volcanic place in the middle of North Island. Signs will come from all over, and they all have long distances to travel. For those who like backwards, New Zealand is running about 50 or 60 years behind us socially. So the way of life is something I can understand. If you want to do something in a hurry, that's 6 weeks. If you're not too much of a hurry, it's perhaps 3 months, because it has to come halfway around the world and so on. They don't keep pigs, or very few anyhow, and so on. It's a world apart from us, but the Morris is really superb. It's mixed, always has been mixed. It's been going since the early 1920s. You know, they've got a long tradition. They have a lot of feedback from the UK because people come over and dance with us and vice versa and so on. But it's alive in a traditional sort of way, which other countries are having problems matching. If any of you get the chance to go, please do. Skip along a bit. I feel responsible for these. If anybody suffers from them, blame me. several sides of specialising. The Duxington Village side took the material that we worked up at Bath and decided to do it nice and differently. Good luck to them. It's much more fun the way they do it. And Wheatley, of course, were a revival, and they've gone again, but were a great thing. Now that represents, right, the Country Dance Society of America published with a cut-off date of 1986, five volumes of material on Cotswold Morris, Northwest, Garlands, Border, and things of that sort. I have produced for workshops over the years a number of booklets listed at the bottom under my nom de plume of Hello Folk from our address. And as far as I know, they're either available from Jerry West or we'll get them on the website in due course. They were necessary at the time they were written because sides were desperate for how they got hold of notations. You know, 20 to 30 years ago, there weren't the notations out there, there weren't the sides out there to be copied and so on. The world has changed since then, I'm pleased to say. Just to show that there is other thing in life other than Cotswold Morris, although you may find it hard to believe. There they are. I've had a professional career that started working on the re-entry vehicle of Blue Street. You notice most of those are nuclear war weapons. Working on the delivery systems for nuclear weapons was a problem with being involved in the Morris world because the Morris world was notably difficult. We went to Barney Morris a weekend at Dudley to dance out to find we were dancing in aid of a CND demonstration. And it was all right. The policeman said, "Oh, bugger off. We're not having you as well." So we went and danced in the shopping mall. But the word got back to my security officer and I had a lot of funny explaining to do. But that kept me busy until I retired in 2000. What did I get out of it? I made it to grade 5, DCSO. That means I was a principal consultant. In fact, I was the principal consultant. I don't know what it really meant, but it helped my pension anyhow. I was proposed for the silver medal. I own a silver medal Royal Air Society. Now, bear in mind that Mitchell's Spitfire Man and people of that sort got the same award. There's nothing to make you feel very small than to be in that list of people. I'm a CBE, if you don't know what that stands for. There are all sorts of popular people get CBEs as well. Funnily enough, and I can't resist telling you, I got this because John Major said, "I'm tired of awards going to people who've served in their post. Haven't we got anybody with talent?" And the RAE Board of Management had struggled to find somebody. That's what they told me anyhow. Right. But I did get a gold medal of the FPSS, a gold badge. And I'm very proud of the Morris Federation. Thank you very much for recommending me for that. Now, tomorrow, we're going to start by working our way through some of these dances. Now, you won't find these in the black book. Well, not three, only find three of them. That's just because the man didn't remember them at the time. But we do have some extra tunes, which the band are competent they can play. I'm not sure they've actually seen them yet. Have you? No, they're gone. That's all right, yeah. And the other lot, where have they gone? I've got two more lists, believe it or not. Uh, As always, of course, thanks for the help I gave myself. I got them in the wrong order. There are the one list of Brackley dances. 22 of those. But Fred Hamer says there was those and those. So we've got a certain amount of work to get through. If you think you're going to get all of them, you're not going to be here long enough, right? But we will get through some samples of them, right? To introduce the things. Now, I brought some other view fours. I don't want to be remembered the way I am. I prefer to be remembered like that. Right? Believe it or not, I've lost the one view four I'm proudest of. What did I do with it? That occupied all my time. I show this picture. First of all, you can get the date because the little baby in the bottom corner is here, there, a good 40 years older, right? But you notice three of them are wearing Abingdon Morris kit, which they were given to by the old men, the older men in my generation at Abingdon, and they all those three dance on occasion. The third one, not the one on the right there, danced from the age of 8 to 14 with the side. The current side doesn't recognise young kids dancing and so on, but they've all danced with Abingdon, so it's part of the family. Yeah. And I have never had responsibility for our village mummers. I was invited to play for them in 1962 because they'd run out, their musician had died. And I played for them for 25, 30 years on Boxing Day. And that was my only involvement. I had been Father Christmas, I was King George, and so on. I hadn't won any of the parts. But I was then fortunate that all seven boys in my family all worked their way through it, all joined when they were about 18, when they're able to drink at the pubs. And we do four pubs on Boxing Day around our village, and they're part of the tradition. Given a family party and so on, we can, there's enough of us to get on and do it. We've only once performed outside the village. We came down to Sidmouth One Festival and ran a workshop, and they performed on the stage. You know, all very interesting experiences. And I'll talk a little bit about the mummers tomorrow. But it's all part of the tradition. I want to emphasise really that I have a background that goes both and covers the tradition as it survives, people I've talked to, people I've seen dance, and also I used to call it the revival of the Morris, but it's not a revival. It's a reinvention of it for the modern days. There's no way what we do looks like the way it was. Because the way it was is you can't recreate the past. When we're talking about the past, we're talking about the 19th century. The way people dressed, the way what people did, how they got on with each other, the sort of village life they lived, what it was like without electric lights, without cookers. You know, I remember going around Bampton and talking to old dancers and their wives, and they're saying, you know, well, how did you cook? And they had a tureen over an open fire, you know, and they were putting the vegetables and meat into that and cooking it in there and keeping it going all week, you know, and fishing it out and things like that. I remember Jinky Wells' son, Bobby, saying, I can never get on with these newfangled sandwiches. You know, a hunk of bread and a hunk of cheese is the way he saw life. You know, and he fought in the First World War. Oh, yeah. He went, he was called up in the First World War. They went by boat to France. When they came back at the end of the war, the old locals said, what was it like? And he said, well, we went in the boat. How big was the boat? And he couldn't describe it. And he said, was it as big as a train? They'd seen a train. A train at Bampton Station, or up the road at Bryce Norton, being three coaches long, was the biggest thing the locals had ever seen. They just couldn't imagine a boat 1,000 feet long. You know, and things like that. You know, it's completely outside of the way of thinking. And so on. It was a different way of life. Fascinating for me to actually go in and talk to people, but I have to say, totally irrelevant to Morris today. Yeah, so I won't bore you with it anymore. But what I will now do is ask you to push your chairs back and we'll have a go at Bampton to Funny Tunes, depending on what I can get the band to play. Well, we'll see how flexible you are.
Right.
What about She Loves You, Lay, Yay, Yay?
Yep.
Yum, bum, dee, da, 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 yum, bum, dee, da, 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 dee, yum. Keep going. She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yum, dum. Ah, you can do that, yeah, yeah. No, you can have the original if you don't want. You don't have to use the transparency if you don't do.
I'll capture these now, and if I can get the originals later, I'll have those as well.
Right. Sets of six with handkerchiefs. Now, there's something you're going to have to learn to start with. Right. I don't care how you actually do your Bampton. One of the rules of this weekend, you do what I ask. And if you know better, you keep it to yourself. Right? I don't want you to confuse the other people. Now, at Bampton, I know from talking to people that for over 80 years, they teach the basic step in one way only. You hop, raising your foot, and then you kick forward, like you're riding a bicycle. Single step, go on, foot and kick. That's right. The kick's on the offbeat. Dum dum da dee da da, dum ba dee da dee da da, dum bum da dee da da, dum ba dee da dee da. Lift and kick, lift and kick. Right. Well, it's not the normal Morris step, as defined by Mr. Sharp, but that's the way they do it. The next thing is that basically it's two bars moving and then back step. And the back step is step, hop, hop, step, and jump. I can't do it. But no. Yan da 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 yan da da yan da di da 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 da. No. Yan ba yan da da di da yan da di yan da da di da. No, I can't hop. Will you do it, please, Barry? One hop, two hop. Right. One hop, two hop, three. Back step. One hop. No. Cut one of those hops out, please. When you go back, sit one step, hop, then step, hop, hop, step, and jump. Right? There's a rhythm about it. Um, pum, pum, pay, um, pum, 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 pum. Right? Let's just try the music again, just that. I say, if you don't believe me, go to here on Whit Monday.
Hmm? We're into She Loves You then, are we? Yes.
Still what?
For She Loves You, yes. She Loves You, yeah, yeah.
Well, we're going to dance the whole dance to it in a moment, yeah. Jump in. Back step. One, two, three. Again. Whoa! Right, we know what the figures are. Foot up and down, half chip. Whole chip and rounds. Right, and the side step, don't worry about the side step, that's just four steps going up and four going down. What you normally do, in other words. The point of what we're doing is that all the connected Morris tunes which we have all date from the middle of the 19th century, and the world's social music has moved on 150 or 160 years since then, right? We've had the music hall, we've had the blackface minstrels, we've actually had ragtime, jazz, and so on. Now, Bampton and Chipping Camden are two traditions which dance. The emphasis is on the offbeat, which is why you've got the kick in this. And I want you to feel that the whole point this weekend is to give you some experiences of things to help you think about doing the Morris. I'm not trying to say this is the way you do Morris. I'm just saying, as far as I can tell, this is the way it was. It's not that what you do is wrong. It's just what you do may not be the only way of doing things. That's all. Let's just try the dance while I sit down. Yeah. I just got to hope I last. Right. Jump. Lift and kick. Back set. And down. Whoa. We had to put up twice, didn't we, with some of these sides? Yeah. All right. Does anybody ever watch that program, Hello, Hello? Hello, hello. The local Patrick comes in and says, watch my lips carefully, I'm only going to say it once. I may only say things once, so watch it. Right, foot up and down. Jump to start, foot up, come on. Jump. Put up, jump, and down. Side step, up. Whoa. Will somebody come forward who knows the Bampton side step movement? Bampton, that's right. You all face me and eight steps up and then turn round. That's right. and then the other way. Yeah, that's all right. I didn't mention that, did I?
No.
No. I assumed you already knew.
Minor omission, yeah.
Ah, don't be worried.
You're going to say it only once or less. Hmm? You're going to say it only once or maybe less than once.
Yes, yes, yes. I appreciate that. Thank you for your cooperation.
Right, are we on?
Right. Any more blunders and I should go home. Jump. Dun, 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 dee. Dun, dun, dee. The other way. Side step up. This way. And the other way. Half hay. Side step down. Half chip. Come on, put some bounce into it. Side step up. Down. Hold chip. And down. Rounds. Last side step now. Up. And down for the last time. All up. What was wrong with that? It's 50 years old. Let's say it's eight of copyright. Don't wait. Too many notes. Oh, blimey. You see, they're complaining about you playing too many bloody notes. It isn't fair, is it?
Take your pick, Mike.
Now, what about Alexander's Ragtime Band? No, I'm going to lengthen the figures.
Okay, fine.
Right, so don't have a worry about shortening the tune.
Right. Do I just play the tune straight, or do you want me to double up bits of it? But we'll see how it goes. You do it.
If you play it straight the way I know it, it's 16 bars of A and 16 bars of B.
I think it is, yes.
Yes, right. Right, now. When you try adapting more modern tunes as anything for the last 150 years, the first problem you find, a tune with a good rhythm, hopefully that one I've had, right, is all the wrong length. On the whole, they do tend to be 16 bars long A and 16 bars B, and what you need for a Morris is 8 bars and 16, right? Now that presents a problem only if you're dyed in a wool. To do the Bampton, what we do is we double the length of the figure, right? When, for example, you do, let's do half ship, walk half ship, da 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 da, and back you go to place. Now 2 bars on the spot, and then do 2 bars, spring capers, turning out in face whatever direction you need for the next figure, next half of figure. Right, they do the other half of half chip. Right, and back. 2 bars on the spot, and 2 spring capers. Otherwise, the chorus is the same. Come on, let's strike up the band. Abraham, Abraham, it's the best band in the... Whoa! Whoa! Now, I said something to you, Barry, about extending the figure, didn't I? Or was it those ladies? You didn't do it anyway, they did. Right? Long figures. Otherwise, the band will keep on playing and you'll get out of phase with the music. They won't notice, but you will. Right, let's try again. I'm having a bad night, aren't I?
That's all right. It was us.
My fault. That's two apologies I owe you. Right. Down Dixie, over him, over him. Alexander's ragtime band. Hey, I'm the meantime. Anthony, face! Face! Ten and Dane. Face. And turn. Sidestep. Over here. Over here. And the dangers rack by halfway. Sidestep. Half chip. On the spot. Turn. On the spot. Sidestep. Chip. Habit goes long, doesn't it? Sidestep. Face up. Hey! Power in. Right. Can you remember Chattanooga Choo Choo?
Yes.
Oh, it's more like I can. I keep forgetting it. That's it. Down under Dundee.
Yeah.
Right. It's Friday night. One last go at this. The same dance, but to a different tune. A much more modern one, of course. It all depends whether you like Glenn Miller or not, as I do. This is my idea of warming up, rather than actually just boom, 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 boom. Warming down. Now, you've got the lesson, we know what we're trying to do. Just try to get that offbeat movement. Right. The next point I want to give you is, as Douglas Kennedy used to say, all movement comes from the pelvis, not from the chest. I don't want to see people wave their arms around without moving the lower part of the body. It's this joint along here that does all the work in English folk dance, right? Whether it's country dancing or whether it's Morris dancing, the effort comes from the hips, right? So put a little bit of welly into your hips. If I can mix the metaphor.
It's all being recorded. Be careful.
You're just vulgar. Right. This one, the same dance, different tune, different period, but it shows you how you can get the same feel. And excitement is what I think the Morris gives to the audience. Rhythmic movement to music is exciting, even though the music's slow, so the music itself is not exciting in its own right. It's the combination that works well. Now, in most cultures, including the English culture, dancing like this for the people who are unwell, particularly those who are...
Like you,
dear. No, I can't think of the word, but people who are depressed. Depressed. People suffer from depression. That's right. People with depression and so on. It works wonders with. Scientifically, it works wonders with. Mind you, I wonder if a scientist ever worked on it, because I can't imagine a placebo for Morris. But if anybody can think of one, please tell me. Can that make a good joke? Right. Here we go. The band plays the tune for the first and last time in their life.
good.
Dave, hold on to that one. No, we'll have that one.
We'll have that one, Dave.
We'll have that one.
Right, that's just the warm-up exercise.
The trouble is, the both of those two are things that a lot of modern school are working on.
That's true.
So you see both of them being used quite a lot with...